To care for you is love. To celebrate you is love. To remember little things about you is love. To reminisce moments with you is love. To miss you is love. To cherish you is love. To be unconditional is love. To still love despite differences is love. I've always yearned to write about love. Through experiences, both personal and vicarious, I have perceived love as a complex emotion. In its nascent form, it has elements of desire, passion, possession, and utopia. As it ages or matures, however, it may transform into a litmus test of one's true character through interplay of complex emotions like envy, fear, impatience, and jealousy. The latter constellation of emotions becomes particularly evident during loss or heartbreak. As an interventional cardiologist taking care of patients in the throes of cardiac emergencies, not infrequently I encounter patients who present to the emergency department with symptoms and signs of a heart attack. Upon further investigation, however, they're diagnosed with broken heart syndrome. In broken heart syndrome, the heart arteries are normal. The heart muscle, however, is severely affected, assuming the shape of a Japanese octopus trap. Loss of an intimate relationship with a person or an object can be so profound that it can literally and figuratively break one's heart. In a study published in the Journal of the American Medical Association by the Cleveland Clinic, we reported a 5-fold increase in the incidence of broken heart syndrome during the COVID-19 pandemic. In broken heart syndrome, the heart acutely loses its ability to pump blood effectively to the rest of the body. We attributed this 5-fold increase in the incidence of broken heart syndrome to personal, economic, and societal losses attributed to the COVID-19 pandemic. The glitter in your eyes, I miss you. The shimmer in your smile, I miss you. The warmth of your hands, I miss you. The belongingness of your hug, I miss you. Those long conversations, I miss you. Those weekend expeditions, I miss you. The silence of our togetherness, I miss you. Only God and the moisture in my eyes know how much I truly miss you. If you've not experienced loss, you have not lived. True love and the experience of its loss is a true game changer. It fosters selflessness. It is endearing. It ejects you from the self-love mode, and perhaps for the first time in life, you begin to nurture the zeal for living for someone else, that someone special. There are no conditions in love. There are no promises in love. There are no reciprocities in love. There is just love. True love is a great teacher. It teaches forgiveness, humility, and sacrifice. Most importantly, it teaches the ability to let go. It makes you realize very quickly that no matter how hard you may try to steer your life in a particular direction, someone up there is writing the script of your life. Now, perhaps the latter notion is antagonistic to the school of thought that life is a construct of our own choices, and I am by no means opposed to that thought. True love, however, I feel is nature's best rebuttal to that thought. It does not happen by choice. It happens by chance, and it takes you by storm. How you deal with it, how you react to it, and what you do about it, however, I agree, are your choices. No matter how driven or focused or goal-oriented or surgical you may be, loss of true love will devastate you. This loss will literally crack your heart open. The emotional turmoil within will consume you. Adverse emotions of rejection and self-doubt will seep in, and you will eventually seek external validation. Cracks and crevices, however, are important, for they also let the light in. Allow yourself time to grow from that pain of loss. Not a day, not a week, not a month, not a year. As much time as you may need, for all of us have different levels of emotional involvements in, investments in, and sensitivities for relationships we allow special places and spaces in our hearts. Learn to focus on getting daily, routine, simple tasks accomplished while going through that pain of loss. Fall back to your basics in survivorship and have faith in your journey. Do the right things, like eating healthy, exercising religiously, meditation, prayer, and hard work. Do them repetitively and do them right. As much as you may want to get angry or cultivate hatred or shift the blame, and in doing this, you'll only destruct and burn yourself. Learn to develop the gratitude muscle for each of these experiences. You will slowly realize that what you are mourning is not the loss of the person, but the inability to make more memories with the person that you've lost. For the person is never lost. The person becomes an integral part of the new you. Through these poems, I've tried to capture the vulnerabilities of true love and its loss. Love, as I've experienced through the emoting eyes of patients and their loved ones minutes before they're being wheeled in for critical procedures in the emergency department and the operating room. As my colleague, friend, cardiologist, and author, Dr. Kavita Chinayan says, language is the thread that weaves together the collective stories made of the colors of pain, suffering, joy, and longing. What are we without language? Even our thoughts and memories are but fragments of words and sounds. As poignant as prose is, poetry is the crowning glory of language. Poetry borders on the mystical, where the words weave themselves together to form the essence of a lived experience. Poetry is revered because this is the kind of experience that each one of us longs for. As the British Indian poet, Dr. Bhanu Kapil says, how do we live when our pain does not dissipate? Is the heart a vector, or is it woven by swift hands on the night before we are born? Have you ever loved someone so deeply that you change species to become a flower? Do not let losses hamper your innocence or vulnerability or convert you into an emotionally inert, impenetrable individual. You will rob yourself from enriching your life with abundant love. Convert your loss into a mission. I use the word mission. For goals are for short term, and missions are for life. Through the energy and the power of true love and its loss, yearn to catalyze the world into a better place. Let your love be legendary. There are no mistakes in life. There are only lessons. Live, learn, and love. Thank you.